First, check the pump and motor. Remove the tow plate for a visual check of the pump and motor underneath the dishwasher. With a flashlight, check for signs of leakage or extreme wear. Remove any dirt or debris from underneath the dishwasher and then replace the tow plate. Next, clean the pump area on the inside of the dishwasher. If the unit has screens or filters around the pump, remove them to clean the sump area from any dirt or food debris. If there is a large amount of debris, advise the member to refer to the owner's manual for proper cleaning procedures. Next, inspect and clean the spray arms. Make sure they rotate easily and are properly connected and are free of clogs and debris. Next, inspect and clean the dispenser. If there's an accumulation of soap, advise the member to refer to the owner's manual for the proper amounts of detergent usage. Make sure the dispenser door opens freely and closes properly. Also check for proper operation during the quick test mode. If the dishwasher uses a mechanical timer, close the dispenser lid and rotate the timer knob to ensure the lid is opening normally. The next step involves checking the heating element for proper operation. Using the tech sheet, put the unit into a dry cycle and then close the door for about 1 minute. Next, advance to the off position and open the door. Check inside to see if the heater is getting hot. Next, check for proper water level and drain operation. Using the tech sheet, verify the proper amount of water needed. Run the dishwasher through a fill cycle, and once it is full, mark the level of water inside the dishwasher. Then, do a cancel and drain to empty the dishwasher. Next, fill the dishwasher with the proper amount of water using a measuring cup and water from the kitchen sink. If the water that was added is the same amount that was marked, it is getting the correct amount of water. Also verify that all of the water has drained during the drain cycle. Inspect the door gasket to prevent leaks. Visually inspect the door gasket is intact and in good condition. Make sure there are no cracks or tears, and clean if necessary. Next, check the level of the dishwasher. Use a torpedo level to verify that the unit is level and adjust the legs if needed. If necessary, check the installation guide for proper leveling of the legs. Check the electronic controls or mechanical buttons for proper function of the dishwasher. If electronic, use the tech sheet to run the dishwasher through the diagnostics mode to verify proper operation of all components. If mechanical, manually advance the timer knob through the functions. When doing this, make sure the door is open. Do not advance the timer manually if the dishwasher is running. Throughout the PM check process, do a visual check of the electrical system whenever wiring connections are visible. Make sure there is proper ground and the connections are secure with no wires being crimped or damaged. Also, inspect for leaks whenever running the dishwasher with water and document the results. Check around the door and by the floor. When the tow plate is off, check for leaks around the pump and motor underneath the dishwasher. Once the PM check is complete, let the member know what was done and what was found with each step. Offer any suggestions to optimize proper operation, such as cleaning the filters or screens and using the proper amount of detergent. This will add to the value of the PM check with the member.